Welcome to this instruction video. For this tutorial, I have permission from Catherine Bly to explain another blanket of her, the Secret Garden. This blanket has 9 different flower squares and a square with a key. And this is the key to the Secret Garden. I do my best to explain the squares step by step, and if you want to see the written pattern, then visit the website from Catherine. The link is below this video. The yarn that we use is Starcraft Special Double Knit, and I use a 4mm crochet hook. I hope you like this tutorial, and we're going to start. In this part we make roses. We need to make 20 squares in total, 8 in the color combination A, 8 squares in color combination B, and 4 squares in color combination C. In this tutorial, I'll show you color combination A. Round 1, and we start with a magic circle. And we start with a chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. And this chain 3 stitches counts for a double crochet. In the magic circle, we work 11 double crochets. Yarn over and go with your hook in the center of that magic circle. And pick up your thread. Yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, and pull through 2. This 1 double crochet, 11 in total. It's 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10, and 11. Now pull on the short tail, your short thread, for closing the magic circle. And then we make a slip stitch in the third chain stitch, 1, 2, and 3. And in that stitch, go with your hook in that stitch. Up your yarn, pull through, and pull through. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round, we use the same color. Round 2, and with the same color, we start with a chain 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this counts for a double crochet plus a chain 3 stitch. Now, in that same stitch where you work a slip stitch in the previous round, you make a double crochet in that same stitch. In the next stitch, a single crochet, a chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and then go back in that same stitch with another single crochet. You make now a bigger loop and a smaller loop. Now we begin on the repeat of this round. In the next stitch, a double crochet and chain 3, 1, 2, and 3, and go back in that same stitch with another double crochet. And in the next stitch, a single crochet, chain 3, and in that same stitch, a single crochet. And that's the repeat. You go all the way around. I'll show you the repeat once more. In the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. And in that same stitch, a double crochet. And in the next stitch, a single crochet. Then a chain 3, 1, 2, 3. And in that same stitch, a single crochet. Go so all the way around, and then on the beginning we work an invisible join. In the last stitch we work a single crochet, chain 3, and a single crochet. And now we cut the yarn for an invisible join and open up your stitch, and with a needle we make that invisible join in the beginning, and we go to the third single of the third chain stitch, 1, 2, and 3, and in that chain, in the third chain we go in that stitch under through that V stitch and pull through. Now you go back to the last single crochet, and then on the top of that single crochet in the middle pull through, and now on the back we work that tails in. End of this round we have 6 loops with the double crochets and 6 loops of single crochets. Round 3, and a new color is on my hook, and we begin with a standing half double crochet in a chain 3 space of a group of 2 single crochets, and that's a little loop. We begin with a standing half double crochet in that loop, now in that same space we work a half double crochet, in that same chain 3 loop 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3, and now go back in that same chain 3 loop with 2 half double crochets, all in that same space, 1, 2. This is your first flower petal. Now we skip the next chain 3 loop space of that double crochets. We skip those stitch of those space, and we go to the next space, and that's the space of that chain 3 with the single crochets. In that space, 2 half double crochets in that space. This one, and go back in that same space with another half double crochet. In that same space, 3 double crochet, 1, 2, and 3, and now go once more back in that same space with 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2, and this is the repeat you made all the way around, 6 petals in total. I'll show you the repeat once more. Skip the next chain 3 space of that double crochets and move over to the next chain 3 space from that single crochets, and start in that space with 2 half double crochets. 1 and 2, and in that same space 3 doubles, 1, 2, and 3, and in that same space 2 half double crochets, 1 and 2. Repeat this 3 more times. I'm done with all the stitches, and on the end of this round we cut the yarn and open up that stitch, and we make an invisible join in the first flower petal, not in the standing half double crochet, but in the second half double crochet. Go always to the second stitch on the through that stitch, from the front to the back, and pull through, and now you go to the last half double crochet of your last flower petal, and on the top of that stitch, through that V stitch, pull through, and this is your invisible join, and weave those threads in on the back of your work. I weave all the threads in on the back of my work, and now we have this. And sometimes you see here a little loop of that double crochets, and we push those two petals to the back of your work. All that loops on the back of your work. And now we have this, a flower with 6 flower petals, and on the back of that flower you have 6 loops. New color on my hook in round 4, and we begin with a standing half double crochet in any loop of a double crochet, chain 3, and a double crochet of round 2, and that's behind your flower in these loops here. Pick a loop and work a standing half double crochet in that chain 3 space. In that same chain 3 space, and half double crochet, and in that same space 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3, and in that same chain 3 space 2 half double crochets for a new flower petal behind your work. Make a chain 1, and now we work on the top of the flower petal of the previous round in the second double crochet and single crochet, but only in the back loop. When you see here your petal, you made here a half double crochet, a half double crochet, a double crochet, and a double crochet, and in that second double crochet we work only in the back loop. This is your whole stitch, this is the front loop, and this is the back loop, and only in that back loop of that stitch we work a single crochet. Just go in the back loop of that stitch and work a single crochet, and now we have to make a chain stitch. And it's really important that you make a chain stitch for that single crochet and after that single crochet. Those two chain stitches we work in the next round, we work double crochets in those chain stitches. Don't forget those two stitches. Now we move over to the next loop, chain 3 loop on the back of your work, and we work another new petal. 2 half double crochets in that chain 3 loop. This is 2, and move your stitch a little bit to the side, and that's 2. In that same space, 3 double crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3, and 2 half double crochets in that same space, 1 and 2, for a new petal. Now we make that chain 1, and don't forget that chain 1 space, and we work a single crochet in the second loop of the double crochet, only in the back loop. This is a half double crochet and half and double crochet and a double crochet, and in that second double crochet only in that back loop of that stitch we work a single crochet. And don't forget then to make a chain stitch. Go so all the way around and we work an invisible join in the beginning. My last flower petal is done. And chain one, and then on the second double crochet only in the back loop a single crochet and chain one, and now we pull up that loop and cut the yarn and we make an invisible join to close this round. Here's your first flower petal, and we skip the first half double crochet, that standing half double crochet, we go always to the second stitch. From the front to the back, pull through, and now we go to the last chain stitch you made, and then on the middle, in the middle of that chain stitch, go in with your needle and pull through, and this is your invisible join. Round 5, and we begin with a new color with a standing double crochet in any chain 1 space after any back loop only single crochet. This is your single crochet, we work only in the back loop of that flower petal here. And this is the chain 1 space for that single crochet, and this is the chain 1 space after that single crochet, and in that chain 1 space we work a standing double crochet. In that same space, 2 double crochets, this one and 2. Now we're working from under behind round 4 petal, and that's this petal here, and then under that petal through that hole underneath that petal, and that's this hole here, and we work in round 3, and that's, I'll show you with the needle, this round in this space here we're working a double crochet and chain 1 and a double crochet, but through the back of that hole of that petal of round 4 around that stitch, and then on the back of your work yarn over and go to that hole of that petal of round 4, and now go around round 3, that space, and pull through the back of your work, pick up your thread and pull through and make a double crochet. Chain 1 and go back to that same space and work another double crochet in that space, and now you see here under that petal of round 4 2 stitches of that 2 double crochets here. I'll show you here once more. In the next chain 1 space, and that's 4 that single crochet in the back loop only. We work 3 double crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3, all in that same chain 1 space. Now in that next stitch, in that single crochet only in the back loop, we work on the top of that stitch another single crochet. In the next chain 1 space, we work 3 double crochets in that same space. 1, 2, and 3. Now we work also around that stitch behind our work. Yarn over and go through that hole under that leaf of round 4 and pick up that stitch of round 3. With your hook, pull through on the back of your work and make a double crochet in that space. And chain 1 and another double crochet in that same space on the back of your work. Now go to that next chain 1 space for that single crochet only in the back loop and work 3 double crochets in that space. 1, 2, and 3. In that single crochet in the back loop only, on the top, a new single crochet in that stitch. And in the next chain 1 space, 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Now we work 2 double crochets between a single and a chain stitch on this stitch here behind our work. Yarn over and go on the through that petal of round 4 and pick up the thread of round 3 and pull it to the back of your work and make a double crochet and chain 1 and in that same space and double crochet. Go so all the way around and then we make an invisible join in the beginning. I work my last 3 double crochets and then on the top of that single crochet in only in the back loop we work the last single crochet and now we cut the yarn and open up and make weer an invisible join. Here's your first standing double crochet and we skip those stitch. Go always to the second stitch and work around that first standing stitch, go back to the last single crochet on the top, pull through, and now you have this. A new color in round 6 and we start with a standing double crochet in any single crochet stitch. And that single crochet stitch you made here between those two groups of 3 double crochets, a standing double crochet in that stitch. And chain 1 and in the same stitch a double crochet. In the next 3 stitches we make a back post double crochet and that's on the next 3 double crochets here. Yarn over and go to that first, around that first double crochet from the back to the front, from the front to the back, And then on the back we work a new double crochet, a back post double crochet. Yarn over, go to the next double crochet, and around that double crochet on the back we work a new double crochet. That's two. And to the next stitch, round the post of that stitch, and back post double crochet. Now we skip the next stitch, and that's on the back, that double crochet on the back. Those stitch we skip, and then in the next stitch, and that's that chain stitch, we work a single crochet. And skip the next stitch, that's the next double crochet on the back of your work. We go to the next three stitches, and that's the next three double crochets, and on the back we work a back post double crochet on that three stitches. This is one. I go to the next stitch, around the post, on the back, and back post double crochet. That's two. And the next one, number three. In the next stitch, and that's that single crochet, we work a double crochet and chain one, and in the same stitch a double crochet. And this is the repeat. You repeat all the way around after those stitches here, go so all the way around, and we make an invisible join in the beginning. Round 7, and with a new color we begin with a standing single crochet in an any chain 1 space, and that's on the top of a petal here in that chain 1 space. You start with a standing single crochet. In the next two stitches we work a half double crochet, and the first stitch is that first double crochet here on the top. A half double crochet. And in the next stitch also a half double crochet. Now we skip the next two stitches, one and two, and in the next stitch, and that's in that single crochet here, we work a shell, and a shell is 5 double crochets with between every double crochet and chain stitch. Yarn over and go to that single crochet stitch and make a shell. It's a double crochet with a chain, double crochet and a chain, and double crochet and a chain, double crochet and a chain, and the last double crochet, all in that same stitch. And now we work 5 double crochets and 4 chain stitches. That's a shell stitch. Now skip the next two stitches, 1 and 2, and in the next two stitches we work a half double crochet. It's 1, and in the next stitch 2. And now in the next stitch, and that's that chain 1 space between the two double crochets, we work a single crochet. After that first standing single crochet here, repeat all those stitches 5 more times and make a slip stitch in the first stitch. Work my last shell, and now skip 2 stitches, and in the next 2 stitches a half double crochet. And I'm done with all the stitches, and now we work a slip stitch in the beginning in the first standing stitch with a slip stitch. Don't cut the yarn. In the next round we use the same color. Round 8 with the same color, chain 3. 1, 2 and 3. And in that same stitch where you make in the previous round that slip stitch, you work a double crochet. Chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same stitch and work another 2 double crochets. One, and go back in the same stitch with 2. Your first 3 chain stitches counts for a double crochet. Now you have made 4 double crochets with between 2 chain stitches in the same stitch. Now skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and go to the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet of that shell stitch, and work on that stitch and double crochet. In the chain 1 space, 2 double crochets in that same space, 1 and 2, on the next stitch, and that's on the next double crochet, and double crochet on the top of that stitch. In the next chain 1 space, 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, and in the next stitch, and that's on the top of that next double crochet, and double crochet. In the next chain 1 space, also 2 double crochets in that same space, 1 and 2, and in the next stitch, that's on the top of that next double crochet, and double crochet. One more time, in the next chain 1 space, also 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, and then on the last double crochet of that shell, we make on the top of that double crochet a new double crochet. Now we skip the next 2 stitches, 1 and 2, and in the next stitch, and that's that single crochet here, we work 2 double crochets in that same stitch, 1 and 2. Now we make 2 chain stitches, and we work in that same stitch 2 double crochets, 1 and 2. And we repeat all those stitches all the way around after that 4 double crochets here. Repeat all those stitches all the way around and make an invisible join in the beginning. End of this round, you should be 13 double crochets on the top of a shell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. 13 double crochets on a shell. Round 9, and we start with a new color. And we begin with a standing single crochet in an any chain 2 space. And that's the space between the 2 times 2 double crochets. And standing single crochet. In that same space, 2 single crochets, 1 and 2. Now we skip the next 2 stitches, and that's the next 2 double crochets, and now we work a 13 time and back post double crochet, and that's on the 13 double crochets on that shell. Yarn over and skip the next 2 stitches and go to the first double crochet of 13 on that shell stitch and make on the back of your work a double crochet. This is 1, and go to the next stitch around the post and make on the back and back post double crochet. That's 2. Go to the next stitch. 3, and in the next, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and on the last stitch number 13. Now skip the next two stitches, and that's the next two double crochets, and work 3 single crochets in the next chain 2 space. 3 single crochets, 1, 2, and 3. And this is a repeat you make all the way around. After those 3 stitches here, all those stitches 5 more times, and make an invisible join in the beginning. A new color in round 10, and we begin with a standing half double crochet in the second single crochet of any 3 single crochets. And these are your 3 single crochets, and then in the second, it's the first and the second, in that stitch we make a standing half double crochet. Once more, and half double. In that same stitch we work 3 double crochets. One in the same stitch. That's 2. Once more, 3 double crochets in that same stitch. And also in that same stitch, a half double crochet. Now skip the next 2 stitches. And the first stitch is then the single crochet, and the next stitch is the first back post double crochet. Those 2 stitches we skip. And then in the next 11 stitches, we work a back post double crochet. So round, and then on the back we make that double crochet. That's 1. 11 in total. 2. Three. 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And now you should be 1 back post double crochet of the previous round. You have 1 over. Skip that stitch and skip the next stitch, and then in the next single crochet, and that's the second single crochet of that 3 single crochets here, we work in that stitch a half double crochet, 3 double crochets in that same stitch, 1, 2, and 3, and in that same stitch a half double crochet. And this is the repeat that you make 5 more times after those stitches here. Repeat those stitches 5 more times and make an invisible join to close this round. A new color for round 11, and we begin with a standing single crochet in the first double crochet of any group of a half double crochet, 3 double crochets, and a half double crochet. This is your first half double crochet, and then in the next stitch, that's the first double crochet. In that stitch we work a standing single crochet. In the next two stitches a single crochet, spun, go to the next stitch, two. Now you made on the top of that three double crochets a single crochet. Now we make two times a treble crochet in each of the skipped stitch of round 8. And if you go down, then you see here two double crochets, and those are two skipped double crochets. And in each stitch we work two treble crochets. Four treble, twice over, and now go to the stitch of round 8. In the first stitch, pick up that whole stitch and make a treble crochet. Twice over and go back to that same stitch and work also another treble crochet. And now in the next skipped stitch, two treble crochets in that same stitch. Spun and two. You have now four treble crochets in round 8. Skip the next three stitches, and that's the next three back post double crochets, and then in the next, and that's the fourth back post double crochets, you make two single crochets. So one, and go back to the same stitch, two. In the next three stitches, a single crochet, one, two, and three, and in the next stitch, two single crochets in that same stitch, one, and go back in the same stitch, two. Now we work also four trebles on this side of the two skipped double crochets of round 8. In each stitch, two treble crochets, twice over, and go to the next stitch of that round 8 in the skipped stitch of round 8 and make two trebles in that same stitch and go to the next stitch and work also two treble crochets in that stitch. Spun, go back in that same stitch, two. Now skip the next four stitches, and that's the next, the last three double crochets of 11. Spun, two, three, and in the next stitch, and that's the first half double crochet. And then in the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet of three double crochets, we work a single crochet, and also in the next two stitches one single crochet. And now repeat after those three single crochets here all those stitches five more times, and then make a slip stitch in the first stitch. In the next round we use the same color. I'm done with all the stitches, and now you have to make a slip stitch in the first standing single crochet to close this round. Round 12, and we use the same color, and we start with a chain 3. 1, 2, 3. And this counts for a first double crochet. Now in the next stitch, we work 3 double crochets in that same stitch. 1, go back in that same stitch, two, and one more in that same stitch and double crochet, three double crochets in that same stitch, in the next stitch and double crochet. Now we have to make and chain one. And then a front post, treble crochet, four together around the next four treble crochet stitches. Yarn twice over and go to the first treble crochet. And then around that first treble crochet on the front, you make a treble crochet, but don't make that treble not complete. Yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. Now you have two loops on your hook. Now stop. Twice over and go to the next treble crochet. Around that treble on the front, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over and pull through two. Three loops on your hook and stop. Twice over, go to the next treble crochet, pick up your thread on the front, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, four loops on your hook, then stop. Twice over and go to the next treble crochet, around that treble crochet on the front, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two, five loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of your five loops. And now it's really important that you make and chain one stitch. In total you make 12 times that front post treble crochet four together, and it's really important that you make four that stitch. We make a chain and after we make a chain stitch. Don't forget those two chain stitches. Now in the next stitch, a double crochet, and that's the first of three. Let's go to the next stitch and double crochet, and in the next stitch and double crochet. In the next stitch we work three double crochets in that same stitch. It's one, go to the same stitch, two, and in the same stitch three double crochets. In the next three stitches, one double crochet. It's one, two, and in the next is three. Now we make a new front post treble crochet four together around the next four treble crochets, but first we make that chain one stitch. Don't forget that chain one. Twice over and make a new together, a new front post treble crochet four together. It's one, and go to the next treble crochet. It's two, go to the next treble. Three, and in the next treble around the front, five loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all of your loops. And then, really important, don't forget that chain stitch. On the next stitch we work a double crochet. On the next stitch we work three double crochets, one, and go back in the same stitch, two, and once more in that same stitch, three, and in the next stitch one double crochet. Now repeat all those stitches all the way around, and I show you once more that front post treble crochet 4 together. But first we make, and don't forget them, the chain stitch. Twice over and make a new 4 together. 1, 2, three and four, 5 loops on your hook, and then on the end we make that chain one space. Don't forget the chain one space. Go all the way around and make an invisible join in the beginning. Round 12, and we start with a new color on the hook, and we note that the stitches that we make in round 12, that chain stitches count also for a real stitch in the next round. We begin with a standing single crochet in the first double crochet here. Of a double crochet, 3 double crochets and a double crochet. In that first double crochet, we begin there with a standing single crochet. Now we make on the next 5 stitches also a single crochet. So on the next stitch, a single crochet. Spun. In the next stitch, 2, in the next stitch, 3, in the next stitch, 4, and in the next stitch, and that's that chain one space, that's number 5. On the next 5 stitches, a half double crochet, so yarn over and go to the next stitch, and that's on the top of that treble together. That's the first. This one. Go to the next stitch, and that's that chain one space. 2, and then on the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet on the top. 3, on the next stitch. 4, and the next stitch, number 5. Now a double crochet in the next 5 stitches. On the next stitch, a double crochet. That's the first of 5. In the next stitch, double crochet. It's 2. In the next stitch, 3. In the next stitch, 4. And in the next stitch, 5. Now we skip one stitch, and that's the last double crochet here, and then in the next stitch, and that's that chain one space, we work 3 treble crochets, chain 3, and 3 treble crochets. Yarn over and go to the chain one space to skip that last stitch here on that double crochet and go to the chain one space and make a treble. This is the first of 3. Go back in that same chain one space with the second treble and back in that same space with a third treble. Now chain 3. 1, 2, and 3, and in that same space, in the chain one space, we make 3 times a treble, all in that same space. This is 1, 2, and 3. And this is your first corner of the square. Now skip the next stitch, and that's the stitch on the top of that treble together. Those little stitch here, we skip those stitch. And then in the next stitch, and that's also a chain one space, we work a double crochet, and that's the first of 5 double crochets. In the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet of the previous round, in the top of that stitch we work the second double crochet. In the next stitch, 3, in the next stitch, 4, and in the next stitch, 5 double crochets. On the next 5 stitches, a half double crochet. So on the next stitch, and that's the last double crochet stitch here on the top, the first half double crochet. Then the second half double crochet, and that goes in that chain one space. 2. The next half double crochet is on the top of that treble together. It's 3. In the next stitch, and that's the chain one space, 4 half double crochets, and in the next stitch, and that's the first stitch after that chain one space on the top, and half double crochet, that's number 5. Now on the next 7 stitches we work a single crochet. So on the next stitch, that's 1 single crochet, in the next stitch, 2, in the next stitch, 3, in the next stitch, 4, in the next, 5, in the next, 6, and in the next, 7. In the next 5 stitches, a half double crochet. So on the next stitch, and that's the last double crochet for the chain one space, a half double crochet. That's the first of 5. In the next stitch, and that's in the stitch of that chain one space. It's 2. Then in the next stitch, and that's on the top of that treble together. 3. In the next stitch, and that's in the space of the chain one. 4. And in the next stitch, and that's the first double crochet next to that chain one space, that's number 5. In the next stitch, we work in the next 5 stitches we work a double crochet. So in the next stitch, a double. In the next stitch, a double. It's 2. In the next stitch, a double. It's 3. In the next stitch, and double, that's 4, and one more double to go, and that's in the chain one space, also a double crochet. Now we skip one stitch, and that's the stitch on the top of that treble together, and go to the next stitch, and that's in the chain one space, and in that chain one space we make a new corner with 3 treble crochets. Yarn twice over, go to that into that chain one space and make a new corner. That's 1 treble, and go in that same space, 2 trebles, and in that same space, 3 trebles. Chain 3, 1, 2, and 3. And go back in that same chain one space with another 3 treble crochets. It's 1, 2, and 3 for your second corner. Repeat all the stitches after the first corner here, all the way around. and be sure that you count all your chain one stitches also. Go so all the way around and then make an invisible join in the beginning. I made my last corner and now we skip one stitch and make in the next 5 stitches a double crochet. And your last corner is made in a chain one space. Skip the next stitch, that's the first double crochet here, and then in the next double crochet you work a double crochet, and that's the first of 5. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In the next 5 stitches a half double crochet, that's 1, 2, 3, and the fourth is in the chain one space, 4, and in the next stitch, that's on the stitch on the top of the treble together, 5. And now we make in the beginning 6 single crochets, 7 single crochets, I'm sorry, we must be make 7 single crochets. We begin with a standing single crochet followed by 5 single crochets, that's 6 together. We must 1 stitch left over and we work there the last single crochet, and that's in the chain one space. In that chain one space we work that last single crochet and that make 7 single crochets together. Now we cut the yarn and open up and we make an invisible join, and not in that first standing single crochet but in the second single crochet. Go back to the last single crochet on the top, and this is your invisible join. Round 14 with a new color on the hook, and we begin with a standing single crochet in any chain 3 space, corner space, a standing double crochet in that space. In that corner space we make a new corner, 2 double crochets in that same corner space, 1 and 2. Now we chain 2, 1 and 2, and in that same corner space we work also 3 double crochets, 1, 2, and 3 for a new corner. Now we work a back post treble crochet around the next 3 stitches. Yarn twice over and go to the first stitch, and that's on the first treble crochet next to the corner stitches, and then on the back of your work we make a new treble. On the next stitch a back post treble crochet around the post of the next treble, on the back we make a new back post treble crochet, and in the next stitch around the stitch on the back a back post treble crochet. Now we work a back post double crochet around the next 5 stitches. So around the next stitch and make on the back a back post double crochet. It's 1 in the next stitch, 2 and around the next, 3, 4 and 5. Now in the next 5 stitches and back post half double crochet. Yarn over and go around the next stitch. On the back, pick up your thread, yarn over and pull through all of your 3 loops for a half double crochet. This is the first of 5, it's 1. Around the next stitch, 2. In the next stitch, 3. 4. And 5. Now around the next 7 stitches and back post single crochet. So around the next stitch, on the back, pick up your thread, yarn over, pull through 2. To the next stitch, that's 2. On the next, 3. 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now in the next 5 stitches and back post half double crochet. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And in the next 5 stitches and back post double crochet. So round the next stitch, on the back and double crochet. This is the first of 5. It's 1. 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now on the next 3 stitches, and that's on the trebles in the corner, we make 3 treble crochet. One treble and go to the next stitch around that treble and make a new treble crochet. That's 2. And around the next treble for a new back post treble crochet. Now in the corner space we make a new corner, 3 double crochets in that same space. 1, 2, and 3. Now we have to make chain 2, 1 and 2, and go back in that same corner space with 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Repeat all the stitches after the corner here. All those stitches all the way around and make an invisible join to close this round. Round 15, and we start with a new color in a corner space with a standing half double crochet. In that same corner space, 2 half double crochets, that same space, 1 and 2 for a new corner. On the next 5 stitches we work a back post half double crochet. Around that first stitch here next to the corner on the back and work a half double crochet and back post half double crochet. This one, go to the next stitch on the back. This 2, go to the next stitch on the back and back post half double crochet. It's three on the next stitch. Four, and on the next five half double crochets, back post half double crochets. On the next three stitches, and back post double crochet. So around the next stitch, on the back, and make a back post double crochet. It's one, go to the next stitch, two, and three. In the next three stitches, and back post half double crochet. So round, and make on the back that half double crochet. It's one, two, and three. Now we work a back post single crochet in the next 17 stitches. So round the next stitch. Then on the back, we work a back post single crochet. It's the first of 17. It's one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, and 17. On the next three stitches, and back post half double crochet. That's one. In the next stitch, two, and on the next stitch, three back post half double crochets. On the next three stitches, we work a back post double crochet. One, two, and three. And in the next five stitches, we work a back post half double crochet. And then first two is on the last two back post double crochets, and the last three stitches are on the stitches of the double crochets. Five in total. This is one, and to the next stitch, that's two, and three, four, and five. Five back post half double crochets. Now we came in the corner, and we make a new corner with three half double crochets in that corner space. One, two, and three. And this is the same corner than the first. And repeat all those stitches all the way around after the corner here. And make a slip stitch in the first half double crochet. In the next round, we use the same color. And that's also the last round of this square. Round 16 with the same color, and it's also the last round of this square. We begin with a chain 2, 1 and 2, and then in the next stitch we work 5 half double crochets in the same stitch, and that's the center stitch of that 3 half double crochets in the center, and that's the second half double crochet. In that stitch, we work 5 half double crochets in that same stitch. It's 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5 for a new corner. Now we work a half double crochet in the next 15 stitches. Let's go to the next stitch. It's 1, and in the next stitch 2, and in the next 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15 half double crochets. Now we make a single crochet in the next 11 stitches. Let's go to the next stitch and make a single crochet. That's 1, and in the next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. And then in the next 15 stitches we work a half double crochet. Let's go to the next and make a half double crochet. It's 1, and in the next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. And now in the next stitch, and that must be the stitch of the second half double crochet of the previous round, in that stitch, and that's the corner stitch, we make a new corner with 5 half double crochets in that same stitch. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And this is the same corner than the first corner. And now we repeat all the stitches all the way around, and then we make the for the last time an invisible join in the beginning. On the end we make 14 half double crochets. It must be 15 in total, but here in the beginning we work 2 chain stitches, and that counts for a half double crochet, and that makes with the next 14 half double crochets 15 in total. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. 11, 12, 13, and in the last stitch number 14, and this is number 15, your first 2 chain stitches. Now we cut the yarn and open up the stitch, and for the last time on this square we make an invisible join. We go always to the second stitch. We skip that first 2 chain stitches, and then in the top of that next stitch we work that invisible join, go to the last half double crochet on the top, and then pull through. Now on the back of your work we weave that thread in, make a little knot, weave it in, more to the other side. And we're done with the square. Now you have to make 8 in color combination A, 8 in color combination B, and 4 in the color combination C. For now, thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye!